Shouts to ban the Chinese products are growing across the globe, especially in India, after the recent killing of Indian soldiers in Galawan Valley by the Chinese. Sentiments to boycott made in China products, apps and services are gaining steam. But can we afford to ban Chinese companies and products? And will that be wise to do so? We will be discussing all that in details in this video. So stay tuned till the end of the video. Hi, my name is Zabik and welcome to 10 Studios, where you can find anything and everything. Let's get started after a short intro. Hi, welcome back. India can't impose a complete ban on Chinese products at all. We don't have any mechanism to stop imports from just one specific country. India and China both are part of WTO, that is World Trade Organization. And due to WTO regulations, one cannot impose ban because in order to export freely, one needs to allow import freely as well. But first, let's try to understand why Indians want the government to ban Chinese products and why there is so much anguish expressed on social media. There are several reasons why people want to ban Chinese products. One of the biggest is to help boost local manufacturers and help native companies to make money and to provide employment. The FAIVM, also known as Federation of All India Vyapar Mandal, said they support stopping import of Chinese goods for creating a roadmap to reduce dependence on Chinese products. But any action should not endanger the ongoing domestic businesses. However, the Indian government has failed to protect the local manufacturing companies. They were sleeping when China made their way inside India and destroyed our industries. On 29 June 2020, the government of India has banned 59 Chinese apps, citing concern for the safety and sovereignty of Indian cyberspace. However, the media is labeling it as a digital surgical strike by the Indian government. It is a bold move and will not go down well with the Chinese dictators, whose official spokesman, Mr. Zhao Lijian, has already cited concerns over it. Now, how deep China already is inside Indian economy, or in other words, how much other industries of India dependent on China for their daily needs? China is India's second largest trading partner after the US. It accounts for nearly 12% of Indian imports across sectors such as smartphone parts, car parts, toys, LED lights, electrical goods, machine parts, chemicals, pharmaceutical inputs, etc., which are critical components of Indian-made products. So, not just the finished products, but several small components which are required to manufacture a product are also made by China. Even if a product says it's made in India, maybe some components of the finished product is made in China and is imported and the final product is assembled in India. According to industry body of Consumer Electronics and Appliance Manufacturers Association, also known as CEAMA, around 95% of consumer electronics and appliances which are produced locally in India depends on China for their components. At least 70% of India's drug intermediary needs are fulfilled by China, said Mr. Sudarshan Jain, president of Indian Pharmaceutical Alliances. He also added that although India has announced a new policy to become more self-reliant in drugs, it will take some time. India's booming smartphone sector also heavily depends on cheap Chinese phones made by Oppo, Xiaomi and others, which already owns a huge share of the local market. Most consumer electronics makers say they will be paralyzed if they can't import crucial intermediate goods from China. Mr. V. Thiagarajan, managing director of Blue Star Limited, an Indian manufacturer of air conditioners, said that we are not worried about finished goods, but most players across the globe import key components such as compressors, etc. from China. He also added that it will take a long time to set up local supply chains and that there are very few alternatives for such kind of imports. Next, Chinese money funds Indian unicorn. Yes, India and China have also become increasingly integrated in recent years. Chinese money, for instance, has penetrated India's technological sector with companies like Alibaba and Tencent. These companies strategically have pumped in billions of dollars into Indian startups such as Zomato, Paytm, BigBasket and Ola Cabs. This has led to China giants deeply embedding themselves in Indian social, economic and technological ecosystem. There have been more than 90 Chinese investments in Indian startups, most of them over the last 5 years. 18 out of 30 Indian unicorn tech startups valued at over 1 billion has a Chinese investor, says Amit Bhandari, an analyst from Gateway House. Next, what will happen if we totally boycott Chinese products? It needs to be acknowledged that Chinese exports to India account for only 2-3% of its total exports. So, even if Indians boycott all the goods imported from China, it will not make any big impact on China. Whereas, it will definitely impact India heavily as Indian manufacturability is limited. Hence, as of now, boycotting all the products from China will not go in favor of India. So, unless and until we develop an ecosystem for various components, it's not possible to reduce dependency on China. It will take some time but cannot be done overnight. We will have to find an alternative which is available globally or can be manufactured locally. India's domestic manufacturing sector can substitute as much as 25% of total imports from China, according to new findings from Acute, a rating agency. This would lead to a reduced import bills of over 8 billion in a single year. Handicrafts, for instance, is a category where India imported around 431 million worth of goods from China in the financial year 2020, without any significant reciprocal exports. Now, you might be thinking, what is reciprocal exports? Let me explain. Suppose there are two countries, country A and country B. Country A imports goods from country B worth of $10 million and exports goods to country B worth of $8 million. Then the $8 million is the reciprocal export, means country A has managed to reduce the total import cost of $10 million to $2 million by exporting goods of amount $8 million to country B. So, is self-reliance the only answer? Every time there is a clash or confrontation with China, there are calls to boycott Chinese products. However, it would be wise to think over before taking any major steps. So, yes, self-reliance could be the answer, but for that, we have to make sure of a couple of things. The first one, become self-sufficient in manufacturing. Till such time as India becomes self-sufficient in producing these goods and spares, it would be difficult to boycott Chinese products. This does not mean we should not. All it means that India would have to set up manufacturing abilities to ensure effectiveness of quality and cost before we begin such large-scale boycott. This will not happen overnight and therefore we need to be patient. So, the need of the hour is to ramp up our manufacturing abilities, increase domestic production, and then look for banning products from such hostile nations. Number 2. Be smart, not emotional. It's time to play smart, keeping our emotions aside. Instead of banning Chinese goods now, we need to enhance our own capabilities, set up a stronger physical infrastructure, and become competitive globally. The best time to do so would be now, as globally there is a negative view about China. Number 3. Handle global forums such as WTO carefully. If made in India products are good and cost effective, then made in India products would always be preferred by Indians. India will have to handle this with care at global forums such as the World Trade Organization. China has since long thrown global business ethics aside and dumped low-cost products into various countries, putting the local native industry and businesses at risk. So, sooner or later, we will have to boycott Chinese goods. But before we do that, we will have to make sure that our country is self-sufficient in manufacturing such goods locally. And for that, we need to ramp up our manufacturing abilities. And then only we can say, vocal for local. Thanks for watching this video. If you find anything you like, then do consider subscribing my channel and hit the like button to show the appreciation. We will meet again with a new video. Till then, take care and be safe. Bye-bye.